Hello everyone, this is Superhero Recaps and today's video is about how a villain becomes a hero when the world needed saving. The story begins with our main character being born and on the eighth day of his birth, his planet is going to collapse. His parents put him in a spaceship along with his partner, a minion, and tell him that he is destined for something. Megamind was unable to hear what he was destined for. He blasts off from his home planet and sees that another capsule has been blasted off with the same idea. Just when Megamind is about to land on Earth in a mansion with wealthy parents, the other capsule hits him, taking his place. While Megamind ended up in prison, Megamind was taught all the bad things by criminals in the prison which intuitively made him evil. He was a genius from the small age and made weapons with his intellect. He also helped prisoners escape prison by making one device. While years pass and since Megamind has good behavior, he was allowed to go to school where he finds the other alien as well. This other kid has super speed, strength, ability to fly, and good luck. And everyone just loves him. Megamind is always the last one picked and nobody likes him at school. Although he is a genius and tries to impress others as well. But they often go wrong, pushing him to have a timeout all the time. His only partner is a minion, otherwise, he is just alone. This is when Megamind feels that maybe he is destined to be the bad guy since he is just bad at things. And the journey of our evil villain begins. The years pass by and Megamind becomes a supervillain while the other kid is named Metroman, defender of the Metro City. This is when we see that the prison warden has again visited Megamind and he has a gift that the Metroman sent him, it's a watch, but instead of giving it to him, the warden keeps it. Megamind is however relaxed because this is part of his evil plan. While walking out, the warden's appearance changes, and turns into Megamind. While the officers hold him and put him in prison, Megamind is hiding there. Turns out, the watch was a disguising device that can change one's appearance. Megamind takes the watch and now walks out as a warden where now they are headed for the opening of the Metroman Museum. We also see another character, Roxanne Ritchie, who is a news reporter. And a rumored girlfriend of Metroman. She is kidnapped in an invisible car, the same car that picks Megamind from prison. This is Minion, now grown and having a huge robot armor. They all go back to Megamind's lair where Megamind meets his brainbots. Changes into his evil costume and sits in his evil hair while Roxanne's consciousness is regained. He tries to scare her but since he has done this so many times that she finds him predictable. On the other hand, the Metroman Museum opening is going on where Metroman is cheering the crowd with his charisma and speech. Just when he inaugurated the museum, black clouds appear and Megamind appears on the screen, revealing that he has captured Roxanne, the crowd boos. Just when Roxanne reveals that they are at a hidden observatory, Metroman instantly gets there since there's only one in the city. Only to realize that Megamind was at a fake observatory while Metroman fell into his trap and right in the target. This is where Megamind plans to kill Metroman. Megamind appears on the screen in the fake observatory again, where they both mock each other just when Megamind tells Minion to launch the death ray and kill Metroman. While Minion tells him that it's going to take time, Megamind feels that his plan is failing again like always. While all this is happening, Megamind realized that Metroman is still stuck at the observatory and it revealed that copper is Metroman's weakness. The death ray is charged now and fires up at Metroman, destroying the whole building. While people are still hoping that Metroman will survive because he always does, a cape flies out from there, and it's a skeleton. Turns out Metroman is dead. The whole town is in shock. And everyone is scared now. Megamind is extremely happy since now he owns the city and no one is there to stop him. While people are sad and scared while Metroman is gone, Megamind has his crime spree and the time of his life. But just in a few days, he gets bored, since there's no fun in being the villain without someone stopping you. He misses Metroman and all the fun they had. The rest of the city misses Metroman too. This is when Megamind visits Metroman Museum to talk to the statue, and Roxanne does the same. Megamind apologizes to Metroman for killing him and tells him that he is going to destroy the museum since they bring back bad memories. Meanwhile, on the other side, Roxanne is talking to the statue as well. When she hears sounds, Megamind runs from there since he doesn't want her to see him in pajamas. This is when he bumps into a museum employee, Bernard. Megamind then takes his appearance and turns Bernard into a dehydrated cube. Roxanne, now talking to Megamind thinking he's Bernard, comforts him since he is extremely sad. Roxanne tells Bernard that not all heroes are born, they can be made as well. This gives the supervillain an idea. To create a hero with Metroman's DNA. That is destined to fight him. They get Metroman's dandruff and create a super cube out of it. The cube has the powers of the Metroman. This is when Bernard's phone rings, and since Megamind has it, he answers it. Megamind before this has never used a phone and is very happy to talk to Roxanne. This is when she tells him that she has found the fake observatory where Megamind hides and is entering. She enters the secret lair and Megamind hides everything and then disguises himself as Bernard to distract her. She finds the hero gun in there and Megamind then tries taking it from her. This is when the shot is accidentally fired, and through pipes, it goes out and hits Hal, who is Roxanne's cameraman and has a huge crush on her. Roxanne and Bernard both go outside to check Hal if he's okay, and Roxanne hugs Bernard thanking him for being so brave in there. Roxanne leaves with Hal and Megamind follows with Minion to Hal's place. Hal is a complete idiot and Minion thinks that this was a mistake. However, Megamind thinks that he is just perfect, and it's fate that chose the hero. Megamind and Minion then break into his apartment and wait for him to transform into Metroman's physique. Megamind disguises himself as an old man and claims to be Hal's space dad that came here to train him. When Hal converts, he is confused and Megamind lies to Hal that he is an alien just so he can become a hero. This is when their training begins, however, they realize that Hal is really stupid. No matter how they try, he doesn't seem to get better. On the other hand, Bernard and Roxanne start hanging out more often, and they are dating now, enjoying each other's company. While Roxanne is sad that Megamind ruined the city, Bernard restores all the things that Roxanne liked, so that she can like Bernard. While this is going on, Hal's training is getting better and finally, he is ready to take up the mantle of the hero. Megamind names him to be Titan. The next day, Minion is making some alterations to the Megamind suit, since it's their great comeback and Minion is really excited. However, Megamind doesn't seem interested in this and is more focused on the dates. This is when Minion confronts him and asks him why is he acting so differently lately and he is not being like a supervillain, to which Megamind accepts that he doesn't want to be a supervillain because they never get the girl. Minion is surprised by all this since they are supposed to be the bad guys. In the argument, Megamind says that he doesn't want Minion anymore, which hurts Minion's feelings and he leaves. Megamind then gets ready for his date. On the other hand, we see that Roxanne is at her apartment trying to figure out the mystery of Megamind's new plan when Hal shows up in his costume and introduces himself to Roxanne. He takes her on a ride without asking her and flies her around. She gets scared and asks Hal who he really is. He takes off the masks and tells her that they can finally be together now since she will now see him differently. However, Roxanne denies any relationship between them and Hal flies off there in anger. Roxanne, however, gets to the date where Bernard is waiting for her and they start enjoying the meeting. When they share a few glances and start kissing, Roxanne's hand touches Megamind's disguise watch, turning him back into his real form. Roxanne now sees him and is scared. She is also devastated by how he lied to her and he is the absolute worst. She leaves the restaurant and Megamind follows her to apologize, however she tells him to leave her alone. Megamind is now back at his lair, telling Minion that he was right and he is sorry, however Minion is not there since he lost him. Megamind, now all alone once again, decides to take over the city now and become the villain since that's what he always does best. He dresses up, gets into his robot armor, and leaves for the city where he waits for the Titan all day long. When Hal doesn't show up, he gets to his place to ask him what's going on, when Hal tells him that he only wanted to be a hero to get the girl, otherwise, he has no interest in saving the world. We also see that he has robbed the city and he offers Megamind to partner up with him. Megamind is disgusted at him and tells him that it was all his genius plan and Hal doesn't deserve these powers. He tells him that he was his trainer and Bernard at the same time, and this infuriates Hal and he attacks him. They are both now in a fight where both of them throw punches at each other. Megamind has finally gotten the adrenaline he needed, which he has missed all this time. Hal defeats Megamind and he tells Hal that it was a great fight and he is ready to go to Prion now. Hell responds to him that he is not going to put him in prison, he is going to kill him. This is when Megamind is really scared since Metroman never said that. Megamind now, with the help of his brain bots, trying to save his life, runs from there while Hell is following him. Since Megamind is unable to defeat him, he uses his final weapon against Hell, that's copper. Which was Metroman's weakness as well. Turns out Hell breaks from it and throws Megamind away, revealing that he does not have Metroman's weaknesses. People around are happy that someone has stood up against Megamind when Hell reveals that they are under a new supervillain, not a hero. Megamind then returns to Roxanne to ask for her help, to see if she knows Metroman's hideout to get some clues about his weaknesses. Roxanne agrees, but only to help to save the city, nothing else. She then realizes that Metroman's fortress was outside the city and takes them there. She asks Megamind why he doesn't take the powers back, to which he replies that he can. But the super gun is in the invisible car that he cannot find since he was sad because of the breakup. They are now at Metroman's hideout, which has a front of their childhood school. They both enter the lair and the place is very nice and clean, instead of finding clues there. They find Metroman, alive and well. They are both surprised and they think that this might be a ghost of Metroman. Metroman then tells them that he wanted to have an out and wanted a life of his own. His was done with this superhero routine. So he faked his death. He said his weakness was copper when it really wasn't. And he survived the accident. As much as Megamind likes his story, he tells him that Hal is destroying the city and Metroman needs to come back, to which he replies that now Megamind has to take up the mantle of superhero of Metro City. Roxanne thinks that this is a perfect plan and can fix everything, while Megamind denies it and tells her he can't do anything. He decides to go back to prison since that is where he belongs, and he submits himself to the warden. Meanwhile, Titan is destroying the city and threatening everyone. When all hope is lost, Roxanne confronts him and tells him to stop. Hal denies it and kidnaps Roxanne. He then makes a video of himself and Roxanne on a tall building and invites Megamind for a rematch. Megamind is watching all this from his cell. And he requests the warden to let him out. He apologizes for abandoning the city and wants to save them. Turns out the warden was actually disguised as Minion and he accepts his apology. They then leave from there and get to the city, where Megamind makes a super entrance which infuriates Hal. He tries attacking Megamind but he escapes. Saving Roxanne on his flying bike, Hal is now angrier and he throws a skyscraper at Megamind, damaging his bike. Megamind threw Roxanne on the side to save her while getting hit himself. Roxanne tries approaching him to see if he's okay. This is when Hal throws a bus at her, trying to kill her. Although he fails while trying to do so, she is saved by Metroman, who is now back in the city to save everyone. Everyone is happy to see Metroman except Hal, who is just scared and running now, with Metroman following him. When Roxanne reaches Megamind, it's revealed that it was Minion in disguise and Metroman is the real Megamind. Metroman then threats Titan to leave the city and never come back. When he comes to the ground, Roxanne changes his disguise, turning him back into his original self. So that everyone can see that Megamind is a hero now. While they think that their problems are resolved, Hal comes back and watches all of this. He throws Megamind around and Megamind is trying to defend himself. This is when Roxanne sees the invisible car with the diffuser gun. She tells him to get it. He gets to the car while running and gets the diffuser gun. Hal throws him in the air again and he's about to fall with his jetpack. This is when he realizes that he has his dehydrated gun and he is going to fall into a fountain. Megamind dehydrates himself and falls into the fountain, where Hal is about to kill Roxanne. Just when Megamind does the superhero landing, diffusing Hal with all his powers and saving the city altogether. Metro City is happy to see the new hero ready to serve them. We then that a few months pass by and the city has created a new museum for Megamind to give him gratitude, and Metroman is now living a happy normal life. If you like this video, check out our channel for more superhero recaps. We do all kinds of stories, from the ones you have seen to the ones you have never heard of. Thanks for watching, Superhero Recaps, signing off.